all your students. In this video, we will be discussing about multiple correlation. The multiple correlation coefficient, capital R, is the measure of the strength of association between the independent variable and one of the dependent variable. Here, whenever the value of R is 1, 1 means plus 1, it implies it is a perfect linear relationship. If the value of R is 0, that implies no linear relationship. If R is 0.9, that means strong association. If R is 0.5, that implies moderate association. And if the value of R is 0.25, it means weak association. We'll have an example and you'll get to know. Just for example, cities, we have got Delhi, Bangalore, Mumbai, Manipur and Kolkata. And we have got crime rates in percentage. In Delhi, the crime is 80. In Bangalore, it is 55. Mumbai, 65. Manipur, 75. Kolkata, 85. Okay, this is just for an example. Okay, do not blame that. How could it is possible? It is just for an example I have taken it. Okay. Now this crime mainly depends upon two variables, that is poverty and illiteracy. If the poverty is more, then the crimes are more. Maybe like you can say in poverty is more in Kolkata, but crime is also more in Kolkata. And it also depends upon illiteracy. Here also you can say illiteracy 75, 20, 60, 65, 80. Illiteracy is more in Kolkata and therefore crime is also more in Kolkata. Okay. So you need to determine that what kind of correlation is there. Is there a linear, a very strong association, moderate or weak association, which depends upon independent and dependent variables. Okay. So over here, you can say A, that is crime, is independent variable over here, and B is dependent variable, even C is dependent variable. Okay, if crime is more, poverty is also more, illiteracy also more, it implies. So we will write it in this manner, capital R. Capital R is mainly used for designating multiple correlation. So capital R, A dot BC. Okay, which implies that A is independent variable and BC are dependent variable. Suppose if B is independent variable, then we'll be writing it in this manner, RB dot AC. And if C is independent variable, then we'll be writing it in this manner, RC dot AB. Okay, but now in our example over here, A is independent variable. So we'll be writing this it in this manner, RA dot BC. So the formula goes somewhat like this, RA dot BC is equals to square root of R square AB plus R square AC minus 2 into RAB into RBC into RAC divided by 1 minus R square BC. Okay. So we'll solve this problem and we'll determine the multiple correlation, the amount. Okay, so with the help of this formula, and we have this formula as well. This is the formula for Karp-Pearson's coefficient correlation, that is small r is equals to summation of xy divided by square root of summation of x square into summation of y square. Okay, with the help of this small r only, we will be calculating the capital R. Now we have got these value A, B, C. A is for crime, B is for poverty, and C was for illiteracy. So first of all, we'll sum up all this thing. Okay, so sum of A is 360, summation of B is 260, summation of C is 300. Now we'll have a few more columns over here. So DA, DB, DC, three more columns. DA square, DB square, DC square. Okay, so we'll calculate DA and then we'll take D square and all those things. So DA is equals to A minus A bar. A value we have got. Now how to calculate A bar? So A bar is equals to summation of A divided by N. Summation of A we have, that is 360, and is the number of observations. So Delhi 1, Bangalore 2, Mumbai 3, Manipur 4, Kolkata 5. So we have got 5 observations, so N value will be 5. Now 360 divided by 5 will be 72. So the value of A bar is 72. We have got the value of A, that is this 80, 55, 65, 75, 85, A value we have got. So for calculating DA, we will subtract A value with A bar. Okay, so to avoid confusion, I am hiding BC value. So 80 minus 72 is 8. 55 minus 72 is minus 70. 65 minus 72 is minus 7. 75 minus 72 is 3. And 85 minus 72 is 13. Okay, we got the value of DA. Next, we need to calculate DB. DB is equals to same B minus B bar. B bar equals to summation of B divided by N. Summation of B we have got 260. So 260 divided by 5 will get 52. So we need to subtract B with B bar, that is 52. So I'll cover up all these things to avoid any confusion. 50 minus 52 is minus 2. 40 minus 52 is minus 12. Again, 40 minus 52 is minus 12. 60 minus 52 is 8. 70 minus 52 is 18. We got DB value also. Next, we need to calculate DC, that is C minus C bar. C bar, again same way to calculate, summation of C divided by N. Summation of C we have got here only, okay, 300 we have. So 300 divided by 5, that is 60. So C bar value of 60, we can aramse calculate DC value. So I'll cover up all these things to avoid confusion. 75 minus 60 is 15. 20 minus 60 is minus 40. 60 minus 60 is 0. 65 minus 60 is 5. 80 minus 60 is 20. Okay, so we got the value of DC also. Next, we need to produce DA square, DB square and DC square. Okay, so first of all, DA square will take 8 square is 64 minus 17 square is 289 minus 7 square is 49, 3 square is 9, 13 square is 169. Okay, next we'll take summation of DA square, that is 580. Next, we'll calculate DB square. Okay, so you need to do square root of DB. Sorry, square of DB. Minus 2 square is 4. Minus 12 square is 144. Again, minus 12 square is 144. 8 square is 64. 18 square is 324. Next, we'll take a sum of DB square. Summation of DB square will be 680. Similarly, we'll calculate DC square. So you will take square of DC. 15 square is 225 minus 40 square is 1600. 0 square will be 0. 5 square is 25. 20 square is 400. Next, again we'll take summation of DC square, which is 2250. Done. Next, we'll make three more columns for DA into DB, DB into DC and DA into DC. Okay, so first of all, we'll calculate DA into DB. So we'll multiply DA with DB. So 8 multiplied by minus 2 is minus 16. Minus 17 multiplied by minus 12 is 204. Again, minus 7 multiplied by minus 12 is 84. 3 multiplied by 8 is 24. 13 multiplied by 18 is 234. We'll take sum of all these things, summation of DA into DB, which is equals to 530. Similarly, DB into DC, we'll multiply this column with this column. Minus 2 into 30 is minus 30. Minus 2 into 15 is minus 30. Minus 12 into minus 40 is 480. Minus 12 into 0 will be 0. 8 into 5 will be 40. 18 multiplied by 20 will be 360. Now we'll take summation of DB into DC, which is equal to 850. Lastly, DA into DC, will multiply this column with this column. 8 multiplied by 15 is 120. Minus 17 multiplied by minus 40 is 618. Minus 7 multiplied by 0 is 0. 3 multiplied by 5 is 15. 13 multiplied by 20 is 260. Next, we'll take summation of DA into DC, which is 1075. This much thing. It is very simple but a bit lengthy, isn't it? So we'll have a box of known values that we have. Summation of DA square is 580. Summation of DB square is 680. Summation of DC square is 2250. Summation of DA into DB is 530. Summation of DB into DC is 850. Summation of DA into DC is 1075. All these values we have. Next, Now we know that small r, that is Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation, r equals to summation of xy divided by square root of summation of x square into summation of y square. We can also write it in this manner, summation of dx multiplied by dy divided by n into sigma x multiplied by sigma y. Okay, we need to use this value. But over here, we need to know the value of sigma. So sigma is equals to square root of summation of x minus x bar square divided by n. You can also write it in this manner, summation of d, square root of summation of d square divided by n, because d is equals to x minus x bar. Okay, so first of all we need to calculate the value of sigma. Okay, first of all you need to get the value of sigma, and after that only we'll get the value of small r, and with the help of small r we can calculate capital R. Okay, so first of all we'll calculate sigma. Okay, sigma a is equals to square root of summation of dA square divided by n. So summation of dA square value we have over here, isn't it? We have it over here. So square root of 580 divided by 5 is equals to square root of 116, which is equals to 10.77. So sigma A is 10.77. Similarly, sigma B equals to square root of summation of db square divided by n. So db square value also we have over here, isn't it? We have calculated previously only. So summation of db square is 680 divided by 5 is equal to square root of 136 is equals to 11.66. so 11.66 is sigma b. Similarly, sigma c is equals to square root of summation of dc square divided by n is equals to square root of sigma summation of dc square is 2250 divided by 5, square root of 450, which is equals to 21.21. so we got the value of sigma a, sigma b and sigma c. Now in this box again we'll write the value of sigma a, sigma b and sigma c. Sigma a is equals to 10.77, sigma b is equals to 11.66, sigma c is equals to 21.21. now once we have got the value of sigma, next with the help of this we can calculate the value of small r with the help of this one formula. Okay, so rab is equals to summation of dA into dB divided by n into sigma A into sigma B. Okay, so now summation of dA into dB, you have this value, isn't it? This is summation of dA into dB, isn't it? Next, sigma A, sigma B, this also we have. Okay, so we have got everything, just you need to put all the values. Now summation of dA into dB is 530 divided by n, that is number of observation is 5, into sigma A is 10.77, into sigma B is 11.66. you have got everything. So just solve this thing with the help of a calculator and you will get the value of 0.844. similarly, RBC is equals to, yes, summation of dB into dC divided by n into sigma B into sigma C. Okay, so dB into dC, summation of dB into dC, this value also we have. Sigma B also we have, sigma C also we have. Just put all these values and calculate. Okay, you will get 0.687. similarly, RAC is equal to summation of dA into dC divided by n into sigma A into sigma C. All these value we have, just keep on adding all the values and go on calculating. Okay, so we got the value of RAB, RBC and RAC. So put all these values in this box. RAB is equals to 0.844, RBC is equals to 0.687, RAC is equals to 0.941. okay, now this is our main formula, but what you can see in this formula, RAB square. So you need to take the square of RAB. Okay, so RAB square 0.844 square, which will be 0.712. okay, now in this formula again I can see RAC square also. Okay, so you need to take the square root of RAC. RAC square is equals to 0.885. similarly, in this formula, in the denominator I can see RBC square also. So our BC square, you take 0.687 square, which will be around 0.471. okay, so I think we have got all these values. So just keep on putting all these values. Okay, so r square ab also we have, r square ac we have, r ab also we have, this one r bc also we have, r ac also we have got everything. Now just keep all these values in the formula. Okay, so 0.712 plus 0.855 minus 2 into RAB is 0.844, RBC is 0.687, RAC is 0.941 divided by 1 minus R square BC, which is 0.471. You just keep on solving these things, okay, and you will get the final result, which is 0.738. so 0.738 is the multiple correlation. So this is a bit moderate association, you can say. Okay, so this is how this is the way how you can calculate the multiple correlation. Okay, so this was all about our today's video regarding multiple correlation. I hope you people found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.